Hello friends, in today's video we are going to see coin change problem. This particular problem has two common variants. One is minimum coin required and another is number of ways. So what are these? In this particular problem we have amount and we have some coin denomination. And in this particular variant our task is to have this amount using minimum number of coins. Okay, minimum number of coins. And in this particular problem we want to figure out in how many ways we can have amount equal to 24 using this coin denomination. Okay, let's see example. See, I have amount equal to 24. So one way of doing it is 10 plus 10 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Another way, 8 plus 8 plus 8. Another way, 1 plus 1 plus 2, 24 times. Do we have another way? Yes, we have. 10 plus 8, 18 plus 1 plus 1, 6 times. So, here it will be 24, here 24, here 24 and here also 24. So, these are some of the options. So, in this particular problem, we see all the options through which we can generate this particular amount. And in this problem, we want to figure out the minimum number of coin required to reach this particular amount. So as you can see among these particular options, the minimum number of coin required is 3 using this particular option. So this is what we do in coin problem and this is what we do in number of ways problem. So this is the problem in brief. Now what we are going to do is we are going to develop an algorithm for solving this particular problem. And as you know, algorithm development is a continuous process. So what we are going to do is, we are going to first apply greedy algorithm here. That is, we will see whether we can apply greedy algorithm here or not. Okay? So as you know, in greedy algorithm, what we do is that we go for the best available option. So what is the best available option here? See, amount is 24, best available option is 10, so we will take a rupees 10 coin and we will be remaining with 40. Got it? Again the best available option is 10. So we will again take a 10 denomination coin and we will be remaining with amount equal to 4. Now see, neither we can take this one nor this. So we can take only one denomination coin. We will be remaining with 3. Again we can take only 1. Then 2. Again we can take only 1. And then it will be 1. And again we can take 1. And then we will have 0. And we don't need to do anything here. So basically I can see here 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So total how many coin required here? 1, 1, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total 6 coins are required in greedy algorithm. But if you analyze this particular problem carefully, we can do better. 8 plus 8 plus 8 will also generate 24 and it will require only 3 coins. So basically what are my conclusion here? What is my conclusion? Greedy algorithm is not going to work here. Okay, so what I'm going to do next, I will see how can I solve it using a brute force method. That is, we will find the brute force solution for this particular problem. Now let's see the brute force solution. So basically what we are going to do in brute force solution, we are going to try all the available options we have, and among all those options we are going to pick the one having the minimum coins. Okay, so our amount is 24. What we are going to do is, we will try one denomination coin, we will again try 10 denomination coin, M coin with 10 denominations. So basically, here I will try 1, here I will try 8, and here I will try 10. So whatever the amount remaining here I will have 23 coin remaining. 23 amount remaining. Here 16 and here 14. I am going to do same thing for this particular option also. That is, I will try 1 denomination coin, 8 and 10. And when I will do this particular thing, I will have 22 remaining here 15 and here 13. Same thing I am going to do for this also and this also. And again I am going to do same thing here for this particular option also. Okay. So the question is that this brute force solution is going to work, that's for sure. But is this particular solution affordable? Is this affordable? Our question is this. And how we are going to analyze it? We will figure out how much time will be required to do this particular thing. See, if you imagine this particular thing as a recursive program, then what will be the problem here? Every function is making a function call to three different functions. What is it? 24 is calling 23, 16 and 14. Similarly, 23 is calling 22, 15 and 13. So, every function is calling three function call. Basically, it is not three, it is the number of denomination. Let D be the coin denomination. Okay? And what will be the height of this particular tree? See here, 24, I have taken one denomination coin, one rupee coin, it reduces to 23. Again, I have taken one rupee coin and it reduced to 22. If again I will take here one rupee coin, which I am going to do of course, so it will be 21. So, this particular tree, this left hand side, we will have 24. That is, the height can grow up to order of amount. Here, n I am taking as the amount. So, height of this particular tree can grow up to the order of amount. Okay? And for every function, we are making three subcall. So, what will be my time complexity for this particular problem? Upper bound? It will be order of d to the power n, where d is the coin denomination available and n is the amount. And in this particular problem, 3 is the coin denomination and 24 is the amount. So the upper bound will be order of 3 to the power 24. Got it? And to understand in a better way, see, here I have one coin, you can assume it as 3 to the power 0. At this level, we will have 3 to the power 1 coin. Here we will have 3 to the power 2 coin. Here we can have 3 to the power 3 coin. So basically total function call will be 3 to the power 0, 3 to the power n, 3 to the power 2, 3 to the power 3. So how much time it can get? How big, how many function call we can have here? 3 to the power n. Okay? Where n is the height of this particular tree. And what is height here? Amount. Okay? So, height is the amount. So, basically what is my conclusion here? This particular solution is not affordable. Why? Because this particular solution is an exponential one. Now, what we are going to do it? We are going to write a recursive program to solve the same thing and we are going to analyze whether we can apply dynamic programming here or not. And I have told you earlier, what is dynamic programming? Dynamic programming is a smart brute force technique. Okay? So, my next task will be to write the recursive program to do the same thing. So, first of all, using def keyword, we are going to define the function. And function name will be coin underscore change. It will take one parameter n. And what is n? Amount. Okay? N is the amount. So, first of all, what we are going to do? We are going to write base case. So, what will be my first base case? If n is equal to 0, we are going to return 0. Correct? And what is my second base case? If n is smaller than 0, we are going to return sys dot max sign. That is basically we are returning infinity. You may be thinking, why this base case? Let's take an example. My amount is 24. If I will take a 10 rupee coin, then I will be remaining with 14. And coin is 1. Again, I take a 10 rupee coin, then 1 plus whatever number of coin through 4. And if again I take a 10 rupee coin, that is this particular option, then it will be minus 6. Is this a valid option for amount equal to 25? No. So what I am going to do is, I will return infinity from here, so that this particular option will no longer be in our consideration. Got it? So this is my second base case. And after that, what I am going to do? I am going to create a variable. Min coin equal to sys dot max size. So I have created a variable, and I will let you know the use of this particular variable in 1 or 2 minutes. Now after that, what I am going to do? For seeing coins, you may be thinking, what is coins? Coins will be the array in which I will be storing these denominations. 1, 8, 10. Got it? So for C in coins, we are going to find out what is the coin needed through each of the option. That is C, when amount was 24, I have gone through all the coins, 1, 8 and 10, then it called 23, it called 16 and it called 14. Basically what I did here, I have tried all the options, and in last what I am going to do is choose the minimum among all the options. And how we are going to do it? We are going to do it recursively. Okay, so coin needed will be equal to, as I have taken this particular coin, 1 plus coin change, as I have taken this particular coin, my amount will reduce, n minus c. Correct? And once I have got the answer of coin needed, then I will do one thing. If coin needed through this particular option is smaller than min coin, then what we are going to do? In min coin, we are going to update coin needed. I think the code is self-explanatory. Return, and once this for loop will execute, that is, I have tried all the options, then I am going to return min coin. Okay, so this is my code for coin change. And now what I am going to do is, I will do a dry run for it. And I will explain how this particular code will execute. And after that, what we are going to do? We are going to check whether we can apply dynamic programming here or not. And this I am going to do in my next video. And if you have liked this video, then please like, share and subscribe. And thanks a lot for watching. And one more thing. See, you can imagine this particular coin change problem as a unbounded knapsack problem. You may be thinking, how? Unbounded knapsack. Here, amount, this particular thing, amount is our capacity of knapsack. Okay? And here, these coins are my objects.